what most spoke to you as a storyteller about this particular project when you first came across it?
Well, just the way that the story was going to be told, that it was going to have different points of view on this one incident, and that you were going to really fully get into every one of those points of view and not just the ones that we as a society romanticize more or revile more. And so it reminded me of like movies like, Shortcuts in a way or something like that, you know.
I think beneath the human drama here in an intimate family setting, we've also got a lot of socio-political themes. I'm curious, as an artist, as a storyteller, how important you think it is to explore those things.
I mean, it's what's on everyone's mind all the time if you don't explore those things. I think there are a couple of different options. There's so much news-wise going on all the time that it's difficult for fiction to be heard because the news feels day-to-day white-knuckle. So in order to be making content that interests people, it can either be complete escapist stuff, which is completely valid also right now. People need to blow their brains out. And then, or something that has something to do with what they're seeing and what's around them, maybe a different idea about it. And I think that's what this is.
For people who haven't been lucky enough to see the film yet, can you tell us just more specifically about your role and where you fit into this drama?
I play Quint, who's somebody who's in the, top 0.01% of wealth. And my wife is played by Marissa Tomei, and she basically, I have a relationship with Liev where he's invested in my fund. And so that goes where funds go, which is high and low.
It's my final question, just very quickly. You're playing someone in that upper echelon. I'm curious if there were particular reference points that you drew upon in terms of real life figures in that community, or if it was just...
I've known people, the wealthiest people, some of the wealthiest people in the world. I've met them. And it's a complicated thing, wealth. You know, I think in the end, capitalism destroys everyone in different ways. The wealthy and obviously the poor,